こんばんは。 Forex TV ニューヨークのレミです。6月23日月曜日の為替レポートニューヨークレビューをお伝えします。23日のアメリカ株式市場でダウ平均は小幅反落しました。ダウ工業株30週平均は先週末比33セント安の11,842.36で終えた。ナスダック総合株価指数は先週末比20.35ポイント安の 2385.74 で終えた。アナリストの利益見通しの引き下げが出て金融株が売られ株式相場全体の押しとなりました。ニューヨーク外国為替市場で円相場は反落しました。弱いユーロ増の経済指標を受けドルが対ユーロで上昇し円安ドル高につながりました。ドル円は先週末55銭円安ドル高の107円80銭から90銭で取引を終えた。24日から25日の米連邦公開市場委員会 FOMC を控えてレンジ内の取引が引き続いています。それでは応援でフューチャーズ&オプションズのトレーダーデレック・フライさんとのインタビューをご覧ください。
Ahead of Wednesday's FOMC rate decision and statement, the US dollar is higher on the day against the euro and cable. Now, today's German IFOM preliminary PMI from the Eurozone added pressure to the euro. Although we're seeing a euro dollar buying in afternoon trade as oil is up on the day. Now, the Fed is expected to stay on hold at 2% while the ECB meeting is on tap for next week. While sideways action is expected ahead of the Fed decision, technically, what's your strategy for euro dollar? And does the latest Eurozone data affect your outlook for the ECB?
The latest data, I'll start with that portion of the question, really doesn't affect my outlook. For the time being, we very much continue to see the euro trading in the range that it's been trading in for the better part of this whole calendar year, or at least the last 3 or 4 months. So we see little on the immediate horizon that would break us out of this range. As you already mentioned, tomorrow's FOMC meeting, or Wednesday's announcement of the FOMC meeting will be, I believe, very much a non-event. You know, I don't think anybody seriously thinks that the FOMC is going to move rates in either direction. Really, at this stage in the game, we feel that all eyes hinge on the price of crude oil right now. If crude oil can maintain itself above the 130, specifically above 135, then that, we feel, could signal a rate hike coming from ECB, as many other people have also kind of talked about. If, on the other hand, crude oil somehow manages to break down below 130, then we would say that a rate hike out of the ECB is taken off the table. So, like most people around the world, we feel that not only us as traders, but even many central bankers are almost fixated on the price of oil, and probably rightly so. It permeates the economy so deeply. But and then furthermore, on the back of the meeting that we just had over the weekend between all the OPEC ministers and whatnot, I mean, they essentially just gave the world the stiff arm, to put it nicely. I think it's a joke that if anybody thinks Saudi Arabia can actually increase production, I suggest they do a little bit more research, because it's unlikely at best that they have any excess capacity. And any excess capacity that they do have is sour crude, not sweet. Sour crude, nobody really wants to refine. It's a much bigger pain to convert that to usable gasoline. So, combine all those factors together and you have, I hate to use the term, but you sort of have kind of a perfect storm brewing right now that could, I think, easily propel us to that 150 level that's been so talked about for these last few months.
以上、応援でフューチャーズ&オプションズのトレーダーデレック・フライさんとのインタビューでした。Forex TV ニューヨークのレミがお伝えしました。最新の為替情報については、Forex TV Japan をご覧ください。